Customers are being challenged today to design spacecraft, satellites, and other space systems that do more on orbit. They have higher resolution sensors. They need to have reconfigurable data channels, faster bandwidth for their data transmission. And the traditional packaging of ceramic packaging that's been used for space applications has become a limitation in how small those systems can get.
So we needed a new type of part that would allow space designers to reduce the size and weight of their satellites, and also to still meet the high radiation requirements. So that's where we worked with industry and also the government to release a new spec called QML Class P. That is a QML rated product, similar to QML Class V, but we released that in a plastic package now.
QMLP is a power density move. You have to think that the same level of reliability that customers have been traditionally used to with ceramic, they can get the same in plastic package in a smaller solution. So imagine that you have, you know, your rad-hard die, which is, you know, at the end what needs to withstand the radiation effects in space, and now you're putting in a very high reliability flow, but in plastic.
We can reduce the size of the plastic packages compared to the ceramic by up to 50%, which means smaller bond wires are inside the part itself. And those bond wires actually add to the resistance and inductance of the device. If we can reduce the resistance based on just the bond wires that are in the part, we can actually improve the efficiency of the total solution.
Because of the reduction in these parasitics, you know, inductance, capacity of parasitics, they also help for high speed applications, right? Devices are able to switch faster, to communicate data faster, and that comes with the use of plastic.
QMLP packages improve the design process for design engineers in that it can make it more like they're used to designing electronics for terrestrial systems, right? The package types are very similar. The PCB manufacturing technologies that can be used are much more similar. The plastic packages come pre-trimmed and formed that make manufacturing more efficient.
Customers actually have a path from a lower cost mission, or what we call a LEO mission constellation, tons of satellites in space, where we have actually the broadest portfolio for that, called a Space EP. There is a pin-to-pin compatibility with this QMLP portfolio. That option to navigate from a different type of mission, a LEO to a GEO or a deepest space mission, has never existed in the past.
Texas Instruments was the leader in developing the QML Class P standard. So we led the committee on that standard, and TI has released the first QML Class P products in the industry.
QMLP is actually part of our really broad portfolio of different grades and different options for space products that TI offers.
We offer every solution for every mission, every customer, every reliability requirement, starting from your LEO constellation applications with the space enhanced plastic portfolio, all the way transitioning to now QMLP as a radiation-hardened option in plastic. We have the traditional radiation-hardened ceramic.
We see QMLP can be used across any kind of mission, but where we see the most importance is on the middle Earth orbit, MEO missions, or geosynchronous orbits. That's where they really have the most importance.
The difference between QMLP and QMLV really comes down to the packaging structure. The QMLV products are made out of a ceramic substrate. They have an open cavity inside where the semiconductor die gets placed in and wired to the pins, and then the pins bring the electrical signals out to the circuit board. You look at the QMLP type plastic packages, there's no air cavity. They're completely encapsulated in a mold compound that's a plastic epoxy.
The radiation testing is exactly the same between the ceramic package parts and the plastic package parts. So we're still doing the exact same level of radiation performance. The reason we do all these tests is to ensure no part failures, because once we launch these things into space, we can't go up there and fix it.
It takes passion and persistence to develop space products. Passion because you must believe that you're actually helping humankind advance in the state of the art with space, right?
There's a lot of effort. There's a lot of, I will say, tribal knowledge that you have to learn over time in order to be good at space. And that's where TI's long history of space development, going all the way back to the 1950s, really benefits us, is because we've been doing this year after year, time after time, device after device.
So engineering the next frontier is really about not being satisfied with where we are today. There's lots of great ideas on how to solve problems and improve things, but the engineering aspect really comes in with turning ideas into real technology and systems that work.
QMLP is one example of those. I'm sure there will be more to come as market keeps presenting different demands. We are ready to tackle those challenges that space, customers, the environment will keep offering.